Well, we live in a social world, right? And we everyday life we interact with other people, and somehow we know that hurting somebody else is bad. But why do we know? And this is actually one of my question of interest, is really how do we learn that indeed when we hurt somebody, it virtually hurts ourselves. And I'm interested in investigating what brain processes, what brain areas help us to decide whether to help or not somebody else that is in pain or in a difficult moment. And in particular, also to understand what brain areas also teach us basically that hurting somebody else is bad or will hurt ourselves. What my research would suggest is that it is because when we see somebody else in pain, we also activate areas of the brain that actually make us feel in pain when we hurt ourselves. No, not everybody has that. That is also quite known and quite clear. First of all, there is a lot of variability, inter-participants or inter-person variabilities in our world. And then you also have extreme cases like psychopathy, in which it's really like an enhancement of a lack of empathy, maybe, or a good control of on your empathy. The clinical aspect is really like to understand what goes wrong in psychopathy or in kids that have these behavioral conduct disorders, basically. And if we would know exactly the mechanism that make us learn that hurting other people is bad, then we can really try to figure out interventions to help these kids to develop a normal behavior. No, I would like to define myself an helpful person, but as everyone else, I think I also compute this cost-benefit analysis, not consciously maybe, but we can't avoid it, and so I cannot say I help every time. But I often help when I can.